again. So here we are in Deepdale. We've just parked up in Patterdale down the way there. And like I say, we're heading up into Deepdale. Now where we're going today, I'm not 100% sure, because there's so many good options really. So the options are Fairfield and St. Sunday Crag, and between the two of them is Deepdale Hause. So when I get to Deepdale Hause, I'll make a decision as where we go. I love St. Sunday Crag. It's one of my favourite Lakeland hills. And Fairfield, well, Fairfield offers a nice sort of ridge walk down Hearts up above Howe once you come down off there. So we'll see what we're going to do when we get to Deepdale Hause. So I should imagine it will be Fairfield, but you know, St. Sunday Crag always appeals to us. So we'll see how we go when we get there. So this is Deepdale. It's a beautiful valley, this, and very secluded. Can sometimes be a bit stuffy because of the lack of wind that gets in here. But apart from that, it is just gorgeous, lovely place. There's loads of glacial stuff going on in this valley. There's loads of moraine and stuff hanging, and hanging valleys, and you name it. You know, it's just geologically, it's a pretty interesting place, I would say. But anyway, we'll plod along the valley and we'll show you some of the views as we go along. So we'll see you along the way. Nice view of Birks up there. This is quite a nice way to come down off St. Sunday Crag. It's a bit scrabbly, but you know, to get back on the same path as you started on, you know, it's as good a way down as any. Not conventional though. Anywho, we'll carry on. We'll back to cross here. Hey. Yeah, don't drink. Don't drink. Nice water. Full of vitamins and minerals, that scout. Yes. Yeah, this valley will start to open up shortly, and we'll get some views of that as we approach it. But it is a lovely valley, this. And yeah, you know, it's you know, Glencoyne, another one in around Ullsdale, Ullswater, sorry. Here's another valley that's quite secluded but quite beautiful at the same time. Like I say, Glencoyne, if you're ever in that area, have a look at that, it's nice. Stone Bridge. We've obviously had a fair bit of water recently. Bit of rain. Good morning. Good lad. Good boy. So you can see that the path up the valley is reasonably level. It's a bit uppy downy and stuff. Nothing too difficult. It gets a bit boggy along the way, but it does start to climb about halfway along the valley, and then it goes very steep when you have to climb up onto Deepdale Hause. It's a bit of a ziggy-zaggy path up there, so you know the bite's kind of taken out of it by the zigzags, but it is steep. But once you're up, it starts to level off a bit. A little bit steep if you head up onto Fairfield, or a Coffer Pike, I think they call it. But nothing too drastic. Well, it's quite rocky there as well. A lot of rocky outcrops and stuff. We've had quite a fair bit of rain recently in Cumbria. It's looking a bit boggy, Deepdale at the moment. But anyway, I'll leave you with this last view, and see, it's pretty beautiful. It's a nice place, like. Lovely.
So, well, there we've got a nice view of Fairfield.
On the right hand side there, you can see where we're heading, which is Deepdale Hause, with Coffer Pike just above it. You've got Greenough End there. Just a point, there's a nice scramble up the side of Greenough End, on the left hand side. It's a bit of a pain to get to, it has to be said, but there's a kind of a gully that goes up that's full of stones, and that's worth a look if ever you come and scramble. Obviously I'm not going to do it myself with the dog. I don't think you'd enjoy it that much, but just a point, if you do go up there, don't try and gain height too quickly, because you wind up on some quite steep ground and it's quite scary, to be honest. Try and get just below the gully before you actually start going up onto the step. That's up above Power Gate. That's looking down the valley towards Patterdale. Beautiful, isn't it? It's a lovely valley, Deepdale. Beautiful place. So we'll push on. Come on, son. And we have somebody who's approaching. We've moved on a little bit. We've been talking to a couple of people on the way up here, so time's moved on slightly. But there's a lovely view of Link Cove, and you can kind of see the path where we're headed now. So not too far to go before we're in Deepdale Hause. And I was told by both people that I met on the way up that the farmers were collecting in the sheep. Looks like they could well be across the way there. So I will push on. There's another view of Link Cove. We're just in the Moran now. We've come up from the main river and valley. And we're just following a track up towards Deepdale Hause. Minor incident with some cows that didn't like the look of a scout, can't imagine why, but fortunately they didn't feel like giving too much of a chase. So that slab of rock there, I think, is Isa Pike, or Isa Crag, should I say. Aye, Isa Crag. Sometimes see rock climbers on there. But yeah, you can see what I mean about the geology of the place. It's fantastic, like. Let's get in this gully. I'm gonna picture of all that moran. There you go. So we just climbed up to see this lovely cascade. It's very beautiful, and indeed it is. So come on, let's go. It's not the orthodox path. Not that there is one, but we're just enjoying the scenery really. Look at that, with that light on it, beautiful. Come on in, boogalugs. See if we can get back on the main path. This is a sheepfold that's marked on the Ordnance Survey map. Quite an impressive one, as you can see. So our path leads up that way, and then we sort of, you know, double back on ourselves to go up onto Deepdale Hause. So we'll probably catch it at the top of Deepdale Hause now. There's a lot of climbing, you know. It's from the bottom of the valley, it starts to get quite steep, quite hard climbing. There'll be people that can climb up here any time, but when getting on in years like myself, I'll take it a bit easier. But you know, it's still beautiful. Still a lovely place. It's quite dramatic. Crags there. Scrambler's paradise. Right then, boogalugs, let's get on. Where we have come up. Sleek Cove, just up the side of Grey Crag, I think they call it. Bit steep, a bit slippy in places, a bit loose, but not a bad little scramble. We've both made it quite safely. So we're near the top now, just a little bit of a push on, and we'll be at the top of Deepdale Hause, and we'll make a decision as to where we're going after that. It looks like St. Sunday Crag, to be quite honest, because it looks like the weather's starting to come in. So probably St. Sunday Crag, but I'll tell you when we get up there. Here we are on Deepdale Hause, just in a nice sheltered bit. And to the left, St. Sunday Pike, which, like I say, I think is gonna be the way we go down. The summit that we go for today. And on the right, that's Copper Pike, and beyond that is Fairfield. And you can see the view from here is absolutely stunning. Stunning views. And over there, on the other side, if we have a walk over there, which I'll do in a minute, as I just want to have a cigarette first. We'll have a look at Grisdale Pike shortly. Grisdale Town. And Helvellyn and what have you. Dollywagon Pike, yada yada yada. So, I'll just scan the view here for you to see. You see great views down into the down into Deepdale and along parts up above Hause. That little crag just on the side there, that's where we came up, which is a bit of a scrambly route, to be honest. The path is actually just over there. The main path comes right to the middle of the Hause. A little bit scrabbly in parts as well, like, but certainly not as hard as that side. I don't know why I came up there, it just looked like it would be something to do, really. But it was quite steep and a bit slippy in parts, and the dog wasn't too happy about it. So he's had treats, haven't you, kid? Hey, haven't you? You had treats. Yes, you've had treats. You want some more treats? Is that what you're saying? He's a nutter, aren't you, kid? Yeah. That's it. Good boy. There you go, Spud. Nice. Yeah, good. Yeah. Good lad. Yeah. So, like I say, I'm going to sit here, have a quick drink, and then probably show you some of the views on the other side. And then head up on to send some to Crag. So see you shortly. Yeah, that's where we were sitting. Come on. Deepdale, which of course was where we came from. Yeah, Crysdale Tarn, really nice. Crag. Yeah, lovely. Lovely place, lovely part of the world. Wish you were. Doing? Hey, what are you doing, boy? He's got his eyes on everything, unbelievable. Anywho, we'll catch you at the summit of St. Sunday.
of it. The summit of St. Sunday Crag. And very pretty it is.
Nice and sheltered.
Nice and sheltered, are you, kidder? Come here.
Unbelievable, aren't you? You're unbelievable, son. Come here. Grab a seat in here.
Nice here. Yes, looks nice here. Yes, it does. It does, boy. Yeah.
Sit. Yeah, sit. Sit.
Hey, 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 sit, sit, sit.
Oh, you big daft dog, you are, eh?
What a big daft dog. Oh, my bum's getting that.
Some left from my last little expedition. Oh, get in. Got biscuits, bag of crisps. Rake away as well. Oh, life's brilliant. There you go. Yeah, you can piss off. There you can piss off. Main path that goes down to Patagonia, But we're going to turn off and we get to Deepdale Common, I think it's called. And we're going to nip down a gill, which will take us back down into Deepdale and back up the path that we started on. And the only reason why I'm doing that is just so as we don't have to walk along the road from Paddledale to where the car's parked. So, as you can see, I've got views of Hause water. The wind is really chilly up here. Where to be? Chilly for late July, anyway. Starting to brighten up a bit, but can't see that lasting long. I was actually thinking of putting my coat on, actually, just to keep the wind out. A nice sheltered bit here. So, and I don't think I'll need it, actually, because when we get to this little saddle here, we head down into that hill there. She'll take us, like I say, where we park the car. You see Birks and Lord's seat there. Another Lord's seat. How many of them they are. So, I guess that's where we're going to head. We're going to head down that gill, back into Deepdale, and back to where the car's parked. So, if you've been watching on YouTube, I'll maybe do some more views as we're going down. Have a bit scooter boot and stuff. But as far as any of the chatter is concerned, that's it. So once again, thanks for watching, and see you again another time. Well, it's a lovely place, you can see. Birks and Lord's seat, or Birks anyway, can't really see Lord's seat much. Oh, then bugger. So far, water course. Oh, you divvy, where you gone? Don't be out with me, eh? Come on, you nutter. It was a good jump though, fella. It was a good jump. Yes. Come on. Don't do it again. Well then, come on. We've got to cross here somewhere, boy. That'll be the best course of action. Come on. Come on. Up. Good boy. Hang fire. Ooh, it was all right. There we go. That's beautiful, isn't it? You know. like I say, to see bits like this, you've got to come off piste or off the beaten track even, if you like. Right then, bugger lugs, let's see what we can do here. Yeah, that's Coldcove Gill there, but like I say, this fence has shifted us away from the gill, and but we have this little gill running into Coldcove, and it's quite amazing, that the rock structure there. I don't know if you can see that fully on the camera. Yeah, interesting anyway. This will take us right down to our path. Woohoo! It would have been a lot easier, I think, if we'd have come down by Lord Seaton and Birks and what have you. Live and learn, I suppose. That folds marks on the map, so we're in the right area. It's a bloody steep path, mine. I don't like to come up it.